Alright guys, today I'm going to show you guys how I have this JVC old school receiver from 1994, which is the JVC AX44, 100 watts times 2, 2 channel. How I have this hooked up to the EQ, which is then hooked up to the Crown Amp XLI 1500, which is pushing a 12 inch power acoustic sub from Walmart. In a ported box. This ported box was a home theater box, which had a trashed 12-inch subwoofer. Anyways, I took that out, popped in this 12-inch. Sounds amazing. And then I also have this 10-inch sound cube. I was using it. Now I'm testing out the power acoustic, which I like. This one hits the lows pretty good. This one's okay. But it still does perform well, and it's pretty impressive for like a $98 sub. Okay, in order to get this subwoofer working with this audio bank EQ, car EQ, and then to the crown, I have this lock from Pack, the SNI 35. And you hook I have the crown amp in mono, so it's just one RCA out. So I have those two wires, which is speaker wires, are connected to the speaker of the receiver. That gives me a signal to run the RCA out. And in order to get bass or the low frequency, I have to have it hooked up to this audio bank EQ. If the sub had its own amplifier, plate amplifier in the back, there would be no need to run the EQ. But since I'm running an external amp, the crown, I have to have this EQ to give me the low frequency. So from here it goes to the crown, and then from the crown amp I have the speaker wires connected to this 12-inch power acoustic. So let's take a listen to this. First song is going to be from Michael Jackson. No bass really in that song, but still, you could hear a little bit. And then I'll put some Kendrick Lamar afterwards. And you guys can listen to the bass. I'm recording on my cell, so it doesn't pick up audio like really well. But you'll get the idea, especially if you're using headphones. Okay? Thanks a lot, guys.